despite the fact that we are getting a new Scream movie in the Scream franchise, the actual idea that they were going to follow up a sequel from Scream 4 is not actually new news, because Wes Craven actually initially wanted a Scream 4, 5 and 6 when he started to make Scream 4, and the studio was so confident that this would happen that they even signed up Kevin Williamson to write Scream 4 and 5 and lead into a 6th movie. And Wes Craven was very, very confident that a Scream 5 would happen following Scream 4, but it never came off until years later after Wes Craven had passed away. So in this video, what I want to do is I want to talk to you guys about what Wes Craven had planned for his version of Scream 5 and tell you exactly how I think they're going to carry on his legacy by recreating some of what Wes wanted to do.
Like scary movies.
Hello?
Hello everyone and welcome to Beyond the Mask, where we talk about all things Scream. If you're interested in Scream content or you just like Ghostface in general, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and make sure you hit the bell icon to stay notified for future content. Just a notice that by hitting subscribe today, you're joining our Scream community in which I'm posting discussions and polls every single day. So by hitting subscribe, you're becoming part of those discussions, so be sure to hit the subscribe button. There's actually some videos around that have actually spoken about this. It's not unheard of news. It's not news that people aren't aware of, but I wanted to do a video on this because we're building up to Scream 2022's trailer, and in order for me to sort of honor the trailer coming out and talk about it, I wanted to do some Scream 5/2022 related videos building up to it. So this is my second one for this week. A lot of people are very aware that Scream 4 was meant to be the start of a new trilogy. It was meant to be the relaunch of the Scream franchise, hence why they were bringing in newer characters and also having older characters in there as well. And one of the reasons why that didn't come off is because the actual Scream 4 movie didn't perform very well at the box office. And in the end, it was just stuck in development hell for months and months and months, to the point where Kevin Williamson was very vocal on the fact that he had stopped working with Wes at one point on it because they were done with him. And I think that's because they sort of maybe blamed Kevin Williamson's script for the decline in success of Scream 4, but because that actually happened, we never got a Scream 5. And Wes had plans for Scream 5 that I think they're going to sort of honour in the new Scream movie. And two of the key features that I actually think were going to happen that we didn't actually get off was, and this one's going to divide so many people, is I do think that Kirby Reed was going to come back. I think that she was going to be resurrected from the dead, because Wes Craven said in an interview that the idea behind the new Scream 5 movie that he was planning was that the survivors of the events of Scream 4 were going to return in Scream 5. Now, this was after Scream 4 came out, so the most fascinating thing with that is that none of them technically survived on screen, and it's widely believed now that none of the characters survived. So, you know, what characters was he talking about? Well, during the commentary for Scream 4, he actually did say during the Kirby scene, he did sort of hint that she maybe wasn't dead. And also on a Twitter post, he also said that he didn't think that Kirby died. She was still moving when she was stabbed, indicating that she hadn't died. So I do think that Kirby was meant to come back. And I think that maybe Scream 5 would have followed her story. Maybe she would have taken center stage. You know, you just never know. The script for the sequels from Scream 4 is sort of a mystery. But the idea that he wanted to continue that would only make sense if Kirby survived. He also dropped hints that Jill survived as well, because in the commentary he said that they removed the gunshot from the head and left it in the chest. And when he was actually asked by Emma Roberts, it could be because she's still alive, he didn't deny or confirm it. He said maybe. So I think that maybe they would have toyed with the idea that Jill was going to come back, or maybe she should have escaped from like an asylum and gone after Sydney again. Scream 2022 seems to be doing the exact same thing that Scream 4 wanted to do. They wanted to sort of reboot this franchise. They wanted to sort of create a whole new wave of fans, but also keep in faith with the original ones. And I always said that Scream 4 was way ahead of its time. I thought that it came out too soon at a time when reboots weren't really a thing, but was more fleshed out on remakes. I think that the reboot aspect of Scream 4 fits in more well now than it did, say, in 2011. And I think that because of that reason, they're sort of mirroring what they wanted to do with that movie, and also they've got Kevin Williamson in to do it. So I do think they're sort of testing to see if this is going to be a success, to see if fans want to see it. Marketing wise, I will just say that I think that it's been very questionable so far. I think they've left it late to promote the movie, but not too late obviously to promote it. But they really need now to bring out a really, really, really good trailer to sort of pull in the audience, and that's going to be something that I want to discuss in a future video. I want to talk about what they need to do with the trailer just before the trailer comes out, and then when the trailer comes out, I'm going to be covering it with you guys and breaking it down and reacting to it. So what do you think about this idea for Scream 4? Would you have actually liked to have seen these sequels for Scream 4 come into fruition? Would you have liked to have seen the idea of Scream 5 and 6 carrying on, maybe Kirby as a character and following her maybe, and sort of seeing her story for 5 and 6? Or would you like to have seen Jill return and maybe break out of an asylum to come after Sydney? What do you think about that? I think it's going to be quite divisive because Scream 4 is one of the more divisive entries in the Scream franchise. So let me know what you think. I always enjoy reading all your thoughts and comments. So thank you very much for watching the video, guys. Don't forget to like the video. That lets me know that you're enjoying this content and gives me an idea of what you want to see more of. Closing off this video, I'm going to leave this on David Arquette talking about the new Scream movie.
And there's an incredible cast. I mean, I think people are really going to be excited about it.
Like scary movies.